In this video, we're going to talk about users and groups in the control panel. To open users and groups, click the arrow to the left and choose groups to create or manage a group in the course, and choose users to access the course roster. Let's choose users, and the course roster opens. In a real course, the course roster will be significantly longer than this, so you can search for a particular user here. Instructors can make no changes to rosters in Blackboard. To create groups in a course, under Users and Groups, click Groups. On this screen, you will see any groups that have already been created, and you will have the ability to create new groups. To create a group, hover over Create, and you can choose to create a single group or a group set. You would choose Group Set when you want to create multiple groups that will all be configured identically. In this video, we're going to create a single group, and we have the choice to allow students to self-enroll or to manually enroll students. We're going to manually enroll, so we click Manual Enroll. Give our group a name, add any description that we want. By default, the group is visible to students, but you can change that depending on why you're creating the group. Under Tool Availability, all tools are by default selected, and you can deselect any tools that you don't want to make available to this group. Under Module Personalization Setting, Allow Personalization is selected by default. If you allow personalization, students can make a number of changes to the group that all students in the group can see. They can change the color scheme of the group and the name of the group. They can also add a module that only the student adding the module sees. If you put a check mark next to Create Smart View, you can filter the grade center to grade only assignments for this group. Last, under Membership, click Add Users to add students to the group. Your roster displays, and you put check marks next to students whom you want to add to this group. And then you submit. Under Membership, you have the option to continue adding or to remove students. If you're satisfied with the membership, click Submit again. And the group displays here. To access this group, you simply click Groups and this screen will display. To edit a group, hover to the right of the group name and choose Edit Group. From this submenu, you can also email all the group members, delete the group, or create a smart view for the group. If you made this group visible to students, the group link will appear under the student's course menu, like this. To access the group, the student clicks this horizontal arrow to the right, or he can open the group by clicking the arrow to the left. Let's go to the group's homepage by clicking this horizontal arrow, and these modules display. Group Properties displays a list of all group members, and clicking the arrow to the right of Group Members allows students to email other group members if you enable the email tool. Under Group Tools, he sees links to the tools that you have made available to this group, and under Group Assignments, he will see links to assignments that you have restricted to this group. Because you allowed personalization for this group, every student in this group can customize the group banner, which means he can change the name that displays to all students in the group, and he can customize the group color, which will display to all students. He can also add a personal module, which displays only to the student who adds the module. Let's edit this group so students cannot personalize it by clicking Groups under Users and Groups, and clicking the arrow to the right of the group name and choosing Edit Group. We'll scroll and deselect Allow Personalization. Submit. And now let's look at the differences that members of this group see. Go to the group homepage. And they no longer have the customized group banner, customized group color, or add personal module options.